Super techno. Yeah, of course. Background background video for like the intermission. So it has some sound to it. So just let me know if it's like too loud. I'm going to whenever you guys are ready. To Sam. It's like too hot or whatever. It's like a thing or whatever.
Is Maggie, does this shit just always go?
Give me a I got your song. Face on there, greatness. Just a
you adjust for today's
this. Nice. Balzi's
well, so gonna fly like already this. In the chat.
Should have thrown up a picture of Green Man.
Yeah, let me know if that's too loud, but I just have like the like a hype video in the background. People in the chat,
yeah,
I'm sure will say something.
You're good.
Right, cool. You got some yeah, Mike Madonna on there, so.
No one's talking right now. I have voice overlay on. No one's talking. Yeah, just like him breathing.
Sammy with the technical difficulties.
Oh.
Nice. Well, if you're just joining us right now, thanks for joining. This is the finals of the Levesque Cup for Barley Hockey Season 9. The Maggles versus Scrub City tonight, and it is 3-1 in favor of the Maggles right now. Game 5 to be played in very shortly. They're going to get puck drop here. All 3 games, if necessary, will be played tonight. So it should be a pretty damn good night. Mm-hmm. All games have been really fucking tight, too. Great goaltending and all the 4 games.
Elite goaltending. Yeah. Elite goaltending.
We have greatness here. He can see his face on the right of me, and there's that's actual picture after being stung by multiple hornets, and yeah. Sammy is in the background today as well. So, but both teams just I mean, I played for 3 of the games, and holy crap, man, yeah, the goaltending has just been spot on, like you said, just elite. Mm-hmm.
Going back, vintage G-Guard, like an NHL 21 G-Guard is back.
Yeah.
He's killing it.
He always steps up for the playoffs.
He packs his greatness face cam or Riot.
Then prepare to Riot.
Yeah, but shout out to Valzi who's in there, you know, rooting for Scrub City, and then Flag Guy is from the Maggles. He's actually, we're going to see tonight playing center, I believe.
Nice.
Yeah, so quality player.
High quality player, yeah. He's been doing well.
Yeah, we got obviously G-Guard in net for the Maggles in their staple, and we have Tyke on the opposite end for Scrub City that you'll see. First game in net for him this series. He played the last 2 at center. You're going to get your bread and butter geezer at center, Barrow on the left, and Whips on the right wing for tonight, followed by Jovels and B-Back, who've been back in Scrub City all season as well.
Where's Martini been?
I just think they opted to not play him. I did see him in the lineup on for game five, but after both losses yesterday, they opted for Tyke in net tonight.
Okay.
Interesting.
I mean, Chad had a shutout on Monday, so I understood why he was in net yesterday.
Yeah, and he still played good. He's played good yesterday, too. Just, Bagel's got the best of Script City last night.
Yeah, it looked like... sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no, absolutely. Go for it, man.
Just looked like the outbreaks for Script City weren't really getting it done. Like, the defensive passing up to the forwards, Mags were just clogging it up very well and putting on a pretty good forecheck, too.
Yeah, cycle lane's going to be key, I think. The Maggles do a good job at almost forcing you to play their way sometimes. And they just kind of ball up in the middle. So if they can get Scripps and can get a moving a little bit there, maybe we'll cycle it down to the point. Or just basically moving the puck a little bit more. And, you know, we'll see if things will maybe kind of shift and get things going. So
Lambo in for Fly. Looks really like.
Oh, Lambo's playing.
Right, we'll get the Lambos. Who,
the good Lambo.
The one game they play, they
I think
did
Lambo's
win,
not even
so.
Here. No, maybe he's the lucky charm.
Or the curse.
Or the Maggles, then, I guess we'll introduce. So, yeah, I guess Lambus the Lambo is going to be solid. Yeah, is going to be centering that line with, if there isn't any other changes, Maggle on the right and Cavi basically playing his first game of the series, I believe, on that left wing. And the back end, we have Seifert, the beef bus, on left D, and Wildcard opposite him on the right side.
The beef bus.
Beef bus. What a fun name.
Yeah, I mean, this game especially, man, it's I'm really excited for this one. I think it's going to be low scoring. I mean, most of the games have been low scoring, so I'm calling a 1-0 again for this one.
You think so? I don't know. I think with the firepower back on Scrub City, I think we're going to have a little bit more than one goal scored.
Yeah. Shout out to Martini also that's in the chat there.
Yes.
Had a solid season, too. Good goaltender.
Yeah. Had some struggles early on due to some lack of effort from his first team, but definitely stepped up once he got over to Scrub City from a trade from it went to Old East, the Maggles, and immediately flipped to Scrub City. And yeah, they got a great player, Martini. Just haven't seen him this playoff, unfortunately.
Yeah, I think Fly Guy is only a three game guy too, right?
Mm.
Yeah,
so I think so. I think he's signed to play.
Opt in to probably save him for 6 or 7. Understandable. That's a good move, I think. Not that Lambo can't shine, but.
Martini, there's nothing wrong with being carried to a cup.
Oh my goodness. I just saw, anyone see who rejoined the league? Gagoots.
The Goots.
This season 7 standout. Welcome back,
Habs
bud.
Fan for MVP. But
I just like saying his name. Right?
I'm say weird. No on that. If it doesn't start with a G, it's probably wrong.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we've got a search going here, and we're already in lobby, so.
Jingle, my Discord's fucking up a little bit. I'm hoping that if I leave the call, it doesn't fuck with the overlay.
Okay.
But if it does, I mean, it could just be on Sammy's face, so.
Okay. Yeah. I don't have you on the live stream, so no worries. It was just on the intermission screen, so no problem. I figured we'd open up the ice a little bit so that people can get a little bit more action.
Okay. Yeah. All right, all right, perfect. Perfect, okay, great.
Yeah, no worries. P-Pack says, see, and you spelled P-Pack wrong. America Bob in the chat. Shout out to
hey,
let's go.
Name change coming soon for Twitch, I assume.
You know what, Stan? I was definitely going to make that same comment with BPAC. It's like, you guys got to make a comeback before you can be MVP.
Is it, has that ever happened? Has a losing player ever gotten a Conn Smythe?
I don't think, you mean in real life or in bar? Because I don't think either way that it should count.
I mean, it's the MVP of the playoffs, not the finals, so.
Well, I mean, the playoff, if it's the MVP of the playoffs, it means he stepped up in the finals, yeah? Stepped up for a win?
Let me know if the audio is a little low, because like, for whatever reason on my end, it's a little low, but let me know if the game audio is okay.
All right, but here we go.
We're off to the races. Yeah, if you're just joining us, Maggles here in purple and white are leading the series 2-1. You're getting the view of the bottom to top from Scrub City here in the black and black and red here. Good interception by Barrow. Goot says, who are we rooting for?
Rooting for everyone. Everyone but Geezer
point.
Now.
Good save by Tyke. Get some early saves. Nice save again there off of Cavi's 1T.
It's not what, there we go.
Do something, Jay.
Arrow up that boards. It's a down low. Seifert's going to find that. And they're going to throw. There's going to be an interception here. And a little reset here for Scrub City.
Set it up.
Another reset. Up to Geezer. Left board. Barrow swerving in. And it's an interception. Wild card intercepts that. And we get a fast break here for the Maggles. It's.
Oh, what a poke.
Maggle getting poked there. Yeah, good poke by Jovels.
Good recovery.
I'm so mad Maggle changed his name.
Was it Seifert gave him $10 to do it?
I mean, for $10? Come on.
I've sold out for less.
How's the game audio? Is it too low or? It just sounds funny on my end, so.
I have an echo because I have the Twitch and the Discord, and I can't figure it out on my phone.
Good poke there. Geezer tries to center that, gets hit.
Can you? I think you can lower it. Oh, wait, you're not on your phone, right?
I am on my phone.
Ooh, then I don't know.
That's fine. As long as my audio is caught up, I guess.
Yeah, I didn't think they could hear the stream, right? So let me see here.
Do we want to hear the game audio, though? Do you really want to hear those announcers announcing over us?
Yeah, I don't know why BPAC's. It might be on BPAC's end. I'm not sure if that's a possibility.
Do you need to turn up BPAC?
I'm all the way up, like 100%
all
on the stream.
All the way up.
I'm all the way up. Oh, there we go. Love your greatness.
We'll try. I'll try to refresh it or something during like. There we go. Here we go. I think BPAC must have turned something up because it just went up by a lot. I'm assuming he's because he's listening to us. So perfect. We're good. Should be good on there, Fly. Thanks for letting us know.
Thank you. And Fly.
Good save by Tyke. Maggle just had to hit the corner, but it went straight. No, that's good, BPAC. Thank you. That's perfect, man.
What did your boy do?
He's fine.
He's just getting just a highlight.
Just a little hurt.
Straight back by Geezer.
All right.
Jovels up to Chaos and misses that connection. That's going for icing. And there we go. Icing is the call. Still 0-0 here in this first period.
Yeah, I mean, hey, you called it. This one's going to be super close, just like the last ones.
It's a little stressful to watch sometimes when it's too close, though.
Lambo wins it. Ooh. Way to hold his short side tight there. Good stop. Yeah, wild card running truculence there. Oh, and a penalty on J-Whips.
J-Whips.
Numbers.
Lambo gets poked. That leaves the zone. We got a 6-on-5 opportunity here now for the Maggles.
Watch that high slot.
Let the goalie score!
Not this time. And Knuckles go on the power play here. Both teams haven't scored a single power play goal throughout this whole series, too.
Unless your name's Krejci, I don't think you're scoring from the net. He's got a net.
Yeah, they always say that like the teams that go far in the playoffs are the ones that capitalize on the power plays, but this has proven that not exactly.
Lambis and Gold tie up. Everybody's going to come through with that, though. Brings it down low. Finally gets it taken away. Here comes Cavi. Interception by BPAC. Gets it the opposite way, and Geezer's going to find that. Behind the net, and that goes in. What a play by Geezer. Dabbing in the middle of the crease.
It's me. Oh, God. I hope he didn't guess that.
What a wrap, though. Short side. And that's a shorthander for Scrub City going up 1-0 in this game.
Off the post.
Look at that. When I said that the teams that go far score on the power play, I normally meant the people on the power play, not necessarily those on the PK. But hey, we'll take it.
He's so good.
What can't he do?
He's so handsome. Good save by Tyke. No tip on the opposite end of that shot from the point.
He's the man with the biggest arms, the greatest charm, and the one who does all the harm.
And he's got Scrub City leading 1-0 right now off of that goal there on the PK. Beef Bus tries to get that across, doesn't find his man in the center. Good layers here by Scrub City, who's now full I can't think of the word. Full strength. Yeah. I can never think of the easy words.
Less than a minute.
Good save by G-Guard.
What's the hard word?
Rash special.
If. I don't know. Good save by G-Guard. He's going to cover that up. 5 seconds left. We got an opportunity for Scrub City here if they win this face-off.
Probably get an aggressive face-off here from Scrub City. There it is. See, if Joe was running tape-to-tape here, be a perfect opportunity to get over to Barrow.
Aggressive. Ooh, one strike back by Lambis. Oh, gets it taken by. Taken away, but good poke by Wildcard. Stays calm. We're going into the second period. 1-0 for Scrub City. Off that great rap that you're watching right now.
Short-handed. Love it. Short kings.
It looks like he's got hair today, too.
Hair geezer.
Yeah.
Cornrow
I think he changed skin color. Oh, no. Never mind. That's Barrow. And perfect opportunity to say hockey is for everybody and everyone. So
all are welcomed.
I love hockey. It's in the stands.
I heart heart hockey.
And come join Bar League. I'm gearing up for season 10. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 9:45. World Cup's coming up as well. We got a little off season events. Should be a fun time.
Yeah, we'll probably get some. We'll probably have Hoagie in here at some point, giving some info on that, and either Chad or one of the other league management will be in tonight too to talk about the owners for next season.
Ooh, nice. Like giving more information on the owners, or like doing kind of like
a
spotlight.
Yeah, I think a soft review possibly.
Okay.
Chad is in the chat, by the way. Too shout out to him.
Hello, Chad.
Oh, Geezer is going in the box here to start the second period.
Uh-oh.
That's not good.
He's trying to keep it close, you know?
But J-Whip's no stranger on the draw, so shouldn't be too difficult.
Tie up or stick lift.
Oh, yeah.
Jay versus Lambo.
Good. Clear by BPAC there. Going to buy about 30 seconds there off that power play. Gavi has some space, though. BPAC is on him. Lambo behind the net over to Maggle. Can't get it out front. Barrow's going to intercept that and gets that 100 feet down. Here comes the beef bus.
On the left
boards. Shot on net, but nobody will find that rebound, and Tyke's going to cover that.
Let's see.
DJ's on it.
A nice diving cover, reminiscent of Chad.
You know, it's, some people like it when the goalie plays it out, but I think it's always nice to reset.
As a skater, I definitely love for the goalie to call it out. But
yeah.
And I'll admit, as a goalie, I do play it out a lot too, because I get bored. But
Lambis' shot blocked by his own teammate. That's going to end this power play. Good interception by Maggle over to Lambis. Intercepted by B-Pack.
What is the Lambis call? Is that new?
Oh, it's because there's no Lambo for some reason as the like announcer call out, and so there's Lambis. Or I think they call it Lambus. So.
Okay. Oh, I can side jokes too. I love to be part of one one day.
Love to be part of one.
Almost a crossbreeze chance there for the Scrub City. Arrow gets it over to B-Pack, gets that block. Jovel's going to pick that up and reset. Good play there, gets it down low. Good poke by Barrow there. Barry.
It was me, Barry.
Better when I'm drunk. That from Beer Fest.
Should put him on your team.
Good play. Somehow J-Whips is not offsides there. Jovel's with it. Gets it down low to Barrow. Tries to get that short side. Gets it blocked. Gets blocked by Wildcard. And Cavi's going the opposite way. 3-on-2. Sends it too far up. Geezer's in the right spot. And you get a penalty here. That's going to be a slash.
Oh, he hit the penalty button.
Cavi going to the box. Mouthing off to the ref. Zebras aren't having it.
Are we going to see Cavi all three games? Can he play all three games? Is he drafted or no?
I'm not sure.
I feel like I haven't seen him too often, so maybe not.
I'm sure Chad will chime in on that.
I lost my stream.
Coming in, Chad.
Cavi can play all three, he says.
Nice. That's awesome.
Lambis taking it himself, almost looking for a wrap there, short side. Geezer a little too far in front, but J-Whips comes up with it. Good save by G-Guard, holds his ground.
Good forecheck by J-Whips. Wow.
Less than a minute in this power play. Gets a cross crease. Good play by Lambis.
Oof. Michigan.
For the bank shot.
Agles get it out. One last rush here for the Scrub City. Good take by B-Pack. It's a cross crease.
Ooh, I thought it was about the offsides, man.
He's around the net again. Gets hit by a wild card.
I think he's down.
Abby's going the other way.
I'm
play by B-Pack. Great defense here so far on the Scrub City side. Oh, Agles has it in the front. Can't find Lambis, and that's going just all over the place, this puck. No shots on net there.
Get some LT going. Yep.
J-Wix almost takes a penalty there. Trying to draw that off the LT. No tip there from Geezer. And
nobody can pick up the puck.
Lambo finds
no one it.
Deep bust from the point to Cavi. Cavi gets poked. Jovels loses it. Another poke by B-Pack. Great defense. Lambis still has it, but they're going to take a penalty, but not a bad penalty there just to release some of that pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Shout out to TJ. Like, if that was me in that, I'd be freaking out. I'd be all over the place. I'd be, like, out of the crease, spazzing back and forth, right, sticking like crazy.
But I can't help but wonder if Jovels didn't run send it, he wouldn't have taken that penalty.
It's possible.
Yeah, what should he have ran instead?
Highly likely. Maggle's going on the power play again.
Any negative thing that comes from Jovels, it's probably because of send it.
Ooh. But that's going in. Great shot from the Beef Bus from the point. Goes under the pad. And they strike quick off of that power play, and it's 1-1.
Rocking that big number 69.
Nice.
He's tracking the half shield too. Nice.
I saw that. I was going to say, like, what is this?
Which one? Like, if you have, like, a jaw injury or something?
Yeah, like, yeah. You need the face shield and you can't get yeah. in the jaw anymore. Yeah.
Is it the fishbowl?
Or if you're back in college. Yeah.
It's the Crosby. Oh, and that and somehow finds its way in.
Oh,
Geezer.
No. Geezer. Dab again.
Didn't have time.
Get into the net.
Oh, was it a?
Own goal, maybe.
Yeah, I think it was an own goal.
2-1 here. They answer quick after that power play goal. Got a minute left in this period. Lambeau picks that up in the zone. Can't find Maggles. Gate interception by Jovels, and we're on the rush here. 2-on-1, 3-on-1.
Ooh.
Great play by Wildcard, or Seifert, rather.
What a poke.
Gabby. A little dangerous. And that's going to end that second period. 2-1 for Scrub City. He finds that go-ahead goal in front of the net.
Does seem like the Maggots really need to start like cycling the puck a little bit more, just kind of slowing it down, moving it around, and you know, trying to get those tips that they're known for.
Yeah, if this goes 7, I'm going to be wasted because I'm 4 shots deep already.
Victory shot? Shots what?
Yeah. But 2-1 here. I didn't get to see the stats there, but I assume it's probably pretty close.
I think the Maggots had 10 shots. That's all I saw.
Yeah. I guess I saw like 10-6 or 10-7.
You know what? Shots don't matter. It's about goals.
Yeah. Most of the games, Maggles have been out shooting Scrub City. So I say the first game that I was playing at net, we got rocked. I think there was like 25 shots or something on net versus our like 10 or whatever it was. So
that was nothing compared to Krejci in game 6 of semifinals, where he faced like 46 shots.
Insane.
In 3 periods.
Yeah, the Maggles at their root just throw it on net and they make extra passes. See if they return to that form. Arrow getting hit, taking that charge, or boarding.
Not the Beef Bus.
The Beef Bus.
5 minutes.
This is going to be rough.
More like the Beef Truck, am I right? Beef Train?
El Pastor. That shit's good if you haven't had that new burrito though from Chipotle.
Is actually really good. Yeah, we just got it the other day.
Fire, dude.
This pork, right? Oh my goodness.
Oh, and a shot.
That's pork
from
or chicken.
Side Jay Whips is putting that in.
Whips.
An unlikely shot from that angle, but puts it in on G Guard.
That's
it was
right,
caught
in
the
office.
Middle. Maybe if he has one T going, maybe kind of froze up G Guard on that.
Well, as you know, there is no counter for that. Despite what those traits say, they do nothing.
Only about 30 seconds into that power play and already a goal, and there's still 4 minutes, over 4 minutes left in that 5 minute major from the Beef Bus. All he can do is just watch his team right now from the glass. Tie up here. Whips is going to come up with that, but actually misses it, and Geezer has it.
Okay. Reset?
Or use that by Jay Whips. That's going 200 feet. Saved by Tyke just to slow it up for Jovels. Hey, sometimes you need that just to get into the game a little bit, you know? So it's a long power play here, so.
Keep the thumbs fresh.
Shot from the point gets blocked by Maggle. Oh, Geezer from the point, man. And that's going cross to Barrow right in front of the net. Still a lot of time on this 5 minute, yeah, too, and we're finally seeing some power play goals. I mean, Sammy alluded to it earlier that the power play goals, you know, once they come, man, they're capitalizing now, so.
Mm-hmm. And a shorty, too.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Well, you know what? It's good to see this intensity from Scrub City because, you know, this is do or die at this point. Maggles up by three. They only need one more to win, so might as well come in hot, let the momentum carry them through the rest of the series.
Yeah, Geezer on his game, playing ungodly in the center right now, and he's going to be in for all three tonight, too, if it happens. Very godly, yes. But not much that G-Car can do there. Already down a man, too.
Yeah. I was going to say, you know, I don't know what the Maggles did, but I know that Scrub City for sure did a warm-up game, and it's showing.
Yeah. They are in full stride.
Yeah, they played a pretty good team, too. I was watching them play. They played, like, Kodanov and Boston Sniper.
Yeah.
Man, there's still 3 minutes left on this power play.
Do you think Kodanov's bar league material? He's not too toxic, right?
No, I like Kodanov. He's actually on, somehow, I just checked earlier today, he's on my friends list for Discord.
Nice. So,
I've always enjoyed Kodanov.
I mean, I know he's got some, he has had some maturity issues, but a very good player.
Good drop pass by Barrow. Cavi's going to find it, though. Wild card up to Cavi. Lambis in the middle of the gold helmet. Almost a good sauce there. Manual sauce.
Ooh, Omaha. Getting a one touch. Ooh,
two on one. Off to the short side. No movement from G-Guard.
Ooh.
Big hit by Lambis.
No, whips doesn't pass, so.
LT's hit behind the net. Finds.
Oh, wow.
Geezer, great save by G-Guard again. Trying to keep his team close in this.
Yeah, I think that's not going to be the first time you hear great save G-Guard all night.
Stop on the point. Another great save by G-Guard. And somehow that finds its way. Wow, I can't believe that didn't pop in. What a bounce that was. At least that power play is over for Scrub City. Here come the Maggles. See if they can get back on the board from the point. Great save by Tyke.
And Wildcard had Cavi, but just didn't see him and opted for that shot instead.
Another horse there in the front. Cavi can't find that one either on that one. Just player didn't pick it up. Good shot from the point. Yeah, and a good save by Tyke. Just nobody there to pick up that rebound. Maggle has some room. Gets it.
So
Maggle putting that in. Keeps his team alive here. It's 4-2 now.
Hits him with the stanky leg. Oh, that's so tough. There's no one can pick up the puck. I love this, James. I mean, this is kind of what I mean. You the old backhand forehand, the old Patrick Sharp.
Yeah, coming in with probably 95 speed too.
The Kittmans still have a big hit to climb here, but they got one. Alright, well. That's the goal they needed. Definitely need to answer there.
Halfway through the third. Let's see if the Maggles are going to turn this up here. They got momentum now. Beef Bus gets that cross. There's no one there. Barrow over to Geezer. Got a little rush here. Down low. Can't find the puck. There's nobody challenging him yet. Nice play by Jay Whips. Gets across. Gets the Barrow. And that's another goal. 5-2. Great pressure by Scrub City. He's all over the Maggles right now in that offensive zone.
Answering right back. Look at the vision.
G-Guard even there just has the desperation save, but.
Yeah, silver 1T is tough.
Yeah, animation just wasn't enough. 5-2 for Scrub City. One straight back here by Geezer. But a reset Cinderella for them.
They got numbers now.
2-on-3. Great pass. Geezer tries to shoot short side, and G-Guard's there. Great save.
Love G Guard's pads too.
Blackout.
The blackout, yeah.
Yeah.
Tie
up? I liked your old Rastafarian pads. Those are sweet.
My Rasta pads are pretty nice.
Great pass and almost connects with Cavi there. Just goes wide. He had the net too. It's unfortunate. Tries to get that cross crease in the middle, and J-Whips now has a break. One-on-one with G-Guard, tries to force it in. G-Guard holds his ground. Great forecheck. Barrow tries to now, and great save by G-Guard again. Just stonewalls him.
Man. If anyone else was in that right now, this would not be a game.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of forehands. Scrub City use that backhand on those one-on-ones.
Or just ram it in. The spear. You know, that's a go-to move.
Yeah. I told you can hit the fucking goalie as long as you have the puck.
What about the Michigan State? The Michigan State spear. My move. An original. A greatness original.
Hey. It's good in my books, man. Especially when you clip it. Here's Barrow, 2-on-2 here. Good LT. Almost found Geezer there, and a tip from the point, and G-Guard's there to save that. Lambo with a little LT, gets poked by Geezer and Jovels. Jovels can't find it out, though, and
look at the back
luckily, yeah, luckily Geezer's there to save the day. Oh, almost a spinorama move by J-Whips, just trying to look for something different here. I don't blame him there. G-Guard's just reading a lot of those up close shots.
They're going between the legs. Panoramas.
Hey, I mean, they're going to win this game right here going into game six. So, I mean, try some new stuff.
Go for the clip show.
30 seconds left.
Stradeek.
And a penalty here. I mean, that's not going to matter much. It's going to be Scrub City taking game five today. So we're going to get a game six. Yeah. Series will be 3-2 in favor of the Maggles. I'm sure we're going to have some lineup changes. I'll have to change my sheet. So,
of course.
And shout out to Max Payne there following. Thanks for the sub, or rather the follow. I don't know if I don't know your name, so I'm just going to add a Discord link in the chat. If you're there just to hang out, though, appreciate you joining us.
One of my favorite PS2 games. That bullet time, baby.
Yeah, that, and if you've ever played like Time Splitters, a pretty fucking cool game too.
What about Blood in the Sand? Was it the 50 Cent video game?
Yeah. Nice. Nineteen seconds left in this game. 5-2, and Barrow's gonna pick that up.
I think they're
looking for more momentum here, Scrub City. We finally found a game that's kind of opened up goal-wise there. My 1-0 prediction was far off.
B-Pack playing safety there. And the Omaha boy goes to the box.
He's holding his head high with this game five victory here. I think that was just him playing trying to rattle Lambis there. Some friend-on-friend action there.
So Omaha, crime on crime.
Sorry, I'm just in time for the game,
man. Yeah. It's not easy playing a league game and doing commentary. We don't blame you.
Well, that's going to be the end of game five. Scrub City staying alive. The series now 3-2.
Get those screenshots.
Good evening, guys. Figured I'd pop in game series for a minute.
Hey, Hoagie.
So, update on the World Cup. We haven't had much of a sign-ups over the past couple of days for it, so me and Dav Smith went ahead and did the draft this evening.
Oh.
Draft is all done. And the teams are made. Teams are in league announcements. We did it by position.
All right.
So it's all, if you want to see the roster, they're there for you. Signups are still staying open until Friday.
Oh, that makes sense. Wow. Okay. All right, fair. I like that.
We just wanted to, you know, do the draft now, and if there's any late stragglers, then we can do that on Friday.
How big are the rosters, anyways?
Roster sizes right now.
Is it 9 apiece?
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 apiece.
All right. Just rattle them off. Why not? We got time. Yeah.
Okay, so Team 1. Team 1 is captained by Jay Whips.
Jay Whips?
Yep. And his roster is consisting of the Dad Smith, Stump, Big D, XX the Peach, Jingle Juice, Dad Bob, Drizzy Rose, and Darius.
That's some heavy deep. Oh, Stump's playing wing, huh?
There's some pretty popular names.
Stump's playing wing? All right.
Yeah. People's choice.
Team 2, captained by Doc. You have Section, Boston Sniper,
Chad
Cheese, Virus, Chad, Jobles, Flashers Fan, and Engvall. Jay Whips and Krejci and the next team all have one roster spot open at the moment. All right. Next team is captained by Dizzy Bone. And his roster is Shamrock, Rhymer, myself, Chinbo, Lizard Spawn, Shawnee on the Spot, Motor City Madman, and Willie Styles.
That's Wizard Pwn Spock, by the way.
Oh.
Star Trek reference.
And the last team, captained by B-Pack.
Shout out.
You have Mizzy Mike, ATS Diesel, Ballsy, Torturer, Master Collier, A. Westfield, P. Mister, JTS Diesel, and Martini.
Mm. I like that first J-Whip squad. That's nice. I think they're whacking a center, though. Maybe Big D can pick that up, but yeah, it looks good.
There are some lineup changes.
I see. I think Maggle's moving to C. I saw Habs Fan on the right, and Cavi's staying on the left wing. And then we got McTricky coming in for Barrow on the left side for the Script City.
Barrow can only play 3 games.
Yeah, so yep. That was his last one. Team China. Nice.
China.
I'm actually excited to play with Drizzy. I love the dude.
Did very you say positive. Teams are RA'd too? Like, so no one actually drafted?
No one actually drafted. We did the teams randomly with a wheel.
Honestly, I was a little skeptic about that, but actually it looks like the teams are, you know, halfway decently balanced, so I think that's as good as you can get.
And we went by position too, so we set off with left wing, did all the left wings, did all the centers, and basically went from there.
Hey.
Well, what did you think, Hoagie? Did you watch the games?
Yeah, I watched a bit of it. I've been playing Xbox as well this evening, so I caught a bit of it. Looked like Scrub City, I mean, overpowered them that game, but doesn't mean anything for Game 6. It's still anybody's series.
Yeah, it doesn't. It's a new game, new life. Maggles leading 3-2, so they could close it out Game 6 potentially.
Yeah.
And I was a part of a down 3-1 comeback in two series in a row, one season. The season I won the cup. And I mean, that's.
How long ago was that?
Like a year ago, maybe.
just making sure. Season 4? Nice.
Yeah,
season 5, I think.
It was definitely not season 5. I remember that one.
Okay, so then it was that season. All right. Anyways, yeah, but I mean, if you can catch momentum, I mean, you never know.
It's true. Good start there for Script City. So.
Script City can build off that momentum. You never know.
Season 4, I didn't sign up, but I was drafted by Fartimus, and Pickles got some shit for it. they just threw me into the draft, and I was not supposed to play.
Yeah, you're good. Anyways, I will hop back out. It's most likely either going to be me or Chad making that announcement.
Okay.
I'm just waiting. I'm just waiting for confirmation from Chad on.
Yeah.
Who's
feel
gonna
free
be
if it. Feel free if there's no winner after Game Six, hop in again at intermission. Love that.
Yep. Mm-hmm. We'll do.
I appreciate the stuff there, man. Talk to you soon. All right, well, I'm going to grab another two shots, so I will be back. You hear some slurred words.
I can talk about geezer. Okay, all right, there, Sammy.
Yeah, go for it. Yeah, I'll be back.
Sammy, how'd game one go?
Not good. Oh, wait, you mean this game?
No. The one your game.
Not good. I joined some Looking for Group games in Bar League earlier, and so I played with Hoagie and Patty and a few others that I don't think were in this league, but they were playing with. Okay. And I played out, try to get some experience, and it didn't go well. So right. It didn't go well. That's, I guess, as much as I can say there.
They stick you on defense, huh?
No, right wing.
Oh, okay.
I mean,
to be fair,
I also just shoot all the time, so that's not the biggest
deal. Well, I remember when you were trying to play out more, they're like, "Oh, we'll play defense," and like defense is arguably the hardest position to learn.
Oh, especially in this game too. Weren't you guys saying that?
Well, it's not just hard to learn. It's dog shit to play, but.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I also I think the problem is that a lot of people most people kind of know the lanes and stuff, but since I'm in goal all the time, I don't exactly see it. So okay. I feel like if you're transitioning from skater to, if you're transitioning from wing to skater or D to wing, sure. Whatever. You at least know what lanes you should cut to or stay back, mm-hmm. or whatever. And I don't. I also just get really lost out there. Like, I watch the wrong person and.
But don't you pay attention during you got season tickets to the Wild, don't you?
I mean, yeah, but that's similar to why I can't be a linesman or something, you know? I get caught up in the game, you know?
I got you.
And then also it's just I'm a level 15 or something like that. So it's I don't have anything unlocked.
You got to send it.
I think I was playing the sniper. So I had close quarters on. Not that I really did anything. But it's a little rough out there when you don't know what you're doing. But, you know. It's fine. It was more of a emergency thing. They would rather I stay in net, so that's how it goes.
It takes practice, though.
Yeah. Just a heads up: if you're gonna bring in your friends to play this game for the first time, I don't know why you would. This game is awful. But if you were gonna bring your friends in who are brand new to the game, don't make them play defense. Have them have some fun scoring some goals, getting some assists, some points. I guess it's one of the easiest positions to learn is forward, so.
Well, you know what? Like I said, I don't know the lanes, and people, I think, don't want to, overstep, and so they're not Sammy, cut here, or, do this, do that. I just kind of, try not to stay in the way. And also, I just, you know, I never played forward on any of the other games, and so, even the just, controls are not exactly natural to me, so, yes, I know the flick up is to shoot, but I don't exactly know how to aim super well or how to wrap or how to do that thing where you go back and forth and then the goalie follows you and then you kind of get them on the far side or whatever. I really struggled. I grinded freaking today. And played all those stupid pro-ams.
Oh yeah.
And I played one's eliminator. Just to get some freaking XP, man, and it was brutal. So
I played that ones mode a month back on old gen. I got chirped at. I was we're on old gen in the worst game mode possible, and I'm getting chirped. This doesn't feel good.
I have to say, I was surprised that no one talked any crap to me because I was legitimately bad. And I actually, so you know, one's eliminator is three people all like one-on-one kind of thing, right?
Yeah, that's
and
awful.
There was one time where like the other two guys like were tied and I was just there just like attacking whoever had the puck, like kind of yeah. thing, and I could not score to save my life, and I legitimately like costed one guy the game, and I was expecting him to like message me and like talk some mad crap, and he didn't, and I was like, whoa, unexpected.
Turns out not everyone who plays this game is toxic.
I was almost disappointed. Like, I was ready. I would have been like, bud, check my level, or like, you're sweating over this. I was ready to talk mad crap back to him, and he didn't even start, and I was a little sad.
It's too bad. You know, yeah. you sometimes you invite that, like, toxicity, but...
I know, I was like, I'm feisty, I'm ready to go, like, I'm in, like, my, like, pit bull mode, let's go, and then he's just like, GG's, and I'm like, oh, go away.
Yeah, yeah, if you're gonna be toxic, dude, be toxic in ones, right? Like, who cares?
Right. It is the also, worst game mode.
Is this, this guy that we're watching stand, is that, BPAX guy? Because it looks just like Brett Burns. And so I don't know bit. If that's like deliberate okay. or if it's just kind of like
no,
shaved
I mean,
head and bushy beard.
I mean, I rock that look. That's what I'm rocking right now. I'm yeah. not trying to be Brent Burns.
It's getting hot though. Are you gonna shave?
What? Oh, well, see, I grow the beard because I want to hide my flaws, and I have a lot of them. So.
So you got to be missing a lot of your upper teeth too. So.
My teeth are great.
We're getting this going. Game six here in the Levesque Cup. Game is the Maggles series, rather, 3-2 so far. And they're in purple here on your upper screen. And white and red, we have Scrub City, who's looking to equalize this series.
So Maggles right now have the server advantage. We'll see if that makes a difference.
And they only need one.
Maggle going to center, so yeah, it's going to affect him the most.
Not many
oh,
changes.
I guess he changed his name previous to last game when they won the two. But I was going to say, maybe it was the Ooh. Name change. Maybe that's the curse.
Somehow that goes in. Geezer finding
oh
another
God.
Way. Starts us off early there, and it's 1-0. I can't believe somehow that wasn't goaltender interference.
But similar to real life, no one knows what goaltender interference is.
Geezer's so good.
You're right. The refs, the linesmen were afraid to call it on him. That's why they let it go.
I would be. You're terrified.
So I have to say, what was that desperation save, bud? Just flopping all over.
The reflection of perfection. The man who got all my attention. Oh, that's him, Ryan.
It's outside. Unfortunate start there for the Maggles. Already down 1-0 here. I got a good poke here from Jay Whips, who's playing the center right now. Oh, and somehow that almost goes in, too. Some weird animations here on G-Guard's side. Maggles looking to settle down here a little bit. Get their game going. And great fucking
oh,
hip check there by Jay Whips.
Oh, he's
Holy shit.
After too.
I'm going to try to get a replay on that. I don't know if that worked. I hit my button, but probably didn't work.
I'm sure we'll see it in the EA replay, too. Maybe not here, but... Definitely at the break.
D-Guard is going to cover that there for a stop. It was a smart move. Oh, Minnesota playing right now?
They are about to. It is end of regulation for Canes and Islanders. And so they've got an overtime. And then I don't know if they're going to cut to the Wild game or not, or if they're going to get delayed.
Yeah, it's 2-2 Bruins versus Florida right now. So.
Oh,
I've been watching the Wild game, though. I watched the last one.
All the way till 1 a.m.?
Yep. I was on the couch, man, watching that.
Uh-oh.
User Ooh. Must
oh,
find another
Steve.
Way. Here comes Habs fan playing that right wing now. A 3-2 Reimer says, hopefully for the Bruins. I guess not. It's like the Florida just went up 3-2.
There's still time though, right?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's just the start of the third, so.
Interesting. Is that
good shot. Great shot from the point from B-Pack. A lot of pressure here on G-Guard. Scrub City finding a way to the net. Look at that ball there from the purple. Maggle side, they're going to move that puck there. Scrub City try to get to the point. Good option there. Almost another tip. Starting to see that movement. Oh, J-Whip's getting nasty there on the sideline there with Cavi.
Face wash, face wash.
Wildcard's hair, man. That always, I always think that someone's wearing like a mask or something. You see that?
I'll have to take a look.
You know what I mean? You see him right there in the right wing? Or right D? This looks like he's wearing like some type of weird mask or something, or like has dreads covering his face.
House fan.
Oh, we got some lag here. Let me see if I can refresh this for you. There we go. Here comes McTricky, who's starting at left wing for this game. Tries to get across to Geezer. Good interception by Wildcard. Cavi with some space, rocking the gold gloves and boots there.
Look out.
Jay Whips gets poked.
Did he try and one hand tuck that?
Not a bad idea. I've seen Lambo do that short side before.
That's
tough to
do.
If that was Lambo, that probably would have gone in. Oh, you hear that, Jay? Are you fired up?
Yes.
He's LT. He almost gets a shot to go.
He's like, I'll show you.
Geezer tries to find McTricky. Good movement here by Scrub City. Got to try to keep that offense moving and try to keep it unique. Got to get different looks on G-Guard here.
Get the stride, Deke. Oh, my
great
goodness,
save by G-Guard. Still behind the net. Tricky gets it over the point. B-Pack gets an unlucky backhander. He's back there on D, though. Good play on Cavi.
Probably should have went back, but...
I go at the point, gets across crease, and somehow blows off a Cavi's stick.
So low puck control.
Beep bus down low to Cavi, and that's getting blocked outside play. Face off in Scrub City zone, 8.6 left in the first. Little Coheed and Cambria. Good block by Geezer. 5 seconds left. Jovel's probably just going to get this out.
Ooh, trying.
And unlucky there. No shot chance for the Maggles. Time runs out. End of the first. Game is 1-0, just like last game so far at the end of the first period.
Wow, what a save.
Yeah, G-Card, all you got to do, keep your team in close, man. Try to let them do the rest.
Where's that hip check at?
Let's see if I can get
the replay.
Yeah, let me see if we can get back to intermission, see if I actually saved it correctly. Probably not, but... See if we got it here. See, maybe. No, probably not. Let's see. It's like a 20-second thing, so... Ooh. Looks like J-Whip's getting hit. Here it comes, maybe. Nope. Oh, there it is. Oh, yeah, there we go. We got it. Replay is on there, baby.
Boom.
That was a hell of a hit. That was a hell of a hit, man. I'm glad my shit worked on that one. I want to see it again, actually. I wish I could speed it up a little bit, but... Ah, we're
Scrub
going to,
City.
We'll save it.
Scrub City out shooting Maggles 11-2. Teams are back on the ice. Definitely out to a slow start for the Maggles.
Tie up here. Maggle comes away with it. Beef bus gets poked. Here comes J-Whips.
Tradeek? Oh, doesn't need it.
Still has it. Gets it to the point. Jovels. Oh, and bad interception there. Luckily, it wasn't going the other way. And offsides.
We're still in the early stages of this period. Calgary's ahead 1-0. Sam, do you still need help with that mute on Twitch thing?
No, that was a while ago. That's why I was quiet for a bit because I was trying to switch to my computer because I could not stand it anymore.
That's going for ice soon.
Oh, you typed it off. How do I mute Twitch on my phone?
Because I was having an echo with you guys, and I couldn't tell if I was late or whatnot. So it's fine. It was driving me nuts, though.
I think there is a mute button on there, no?
I couldn't tell. I was pressing everything. It just kept asking me if I wanted to subscribe to BPAC. I'm sorry, BPAC. I do not want to pay you $6.90 or $6.99 or whatever.
The Magic 8 Ball is not in favor of the Maggles right now, so they're not going to tie this game up. He's usually not right, though. So let's see what happens. Need some stats on the 8-ball here. Good save by Tyke. Maggles starting to get a little bit of pressure here, so just trying to work their way back into this game, only down by one.
I think technically I could figure it out if I had the time. I could figure out what the
percentages. Back in all the old streams.
Yeah.
Next season. Season 10, we're getting 8-ball stats.
There we go.
First league to ever do that.
8-ball analytics.
Great shot from the point and a tip there. Great save by Tyke, though, is in position for that.
I think he might have had Cavi.
Teaser. LT's it. Somehow finds almost the back of the net.
He's in himself, but the puck is not.
I like the creativeness.
The league.
They got to get creative to get it past G Guard here.
Offside again.
Oh my gosh. Act like professionals, boys. This is the finals.
Very reminiscent of that game one from the Maggles, that blue line defense that they had against Scrub City. I say the F word all the time. Oh, and what a shot by Habs fan from the point and ties this up 1-1.
That is something you don't see in NHL 23.
8-ball analytics are wrong. So it's 0-1 already. But Habs fan, CN screaming Habs fan in chat, ties this game up in the second, almost halfway through this game.
What a snipe. Jeez. Just got enough on that screen.
Last game, Scrub City equalizing very quickly. See what happens here. We got a 3-on-2.
Ooh, but it enters it on the wrong side.
Maggle at the point. Gets a cross, and that's going in. Cavi finishes it off. 2-1 for the Maggles.
It was there last time, too.
Maggle says, we're tired. We want to watch real playoff hockey. Let's end this.
This is real playoff hockey.
They just scored on Fleury. Why is he in the net today? Why?
Yeah, why change goaltenders? That's strange.
I don't understand. I get that we're in overtime, and I get that.
Uh-oh.
Chance here for the Maggles. Great hold by Tyke. Halfway through this game now, 2-1 for Maggles, looking to close this series off. They're finding their rhythm now. Another shot from Maggles to Cavi. Great save by Tyke this time, though. He's trying to read that.
Oh,
great
my
shot
goodness.
By. Oh, and we got interference on probably Jay Whips there, I think.
Oh, man. What a finish.
Yeah.
Yep, Jay.
And that goal's coming back.
How unfortunate.
You know, they can just do it again. Sometimes I feel like when the goals get called back, like, it kind of still ruins your goalie's confidence. So. Don't give up on it.
I feel like it's more of a sigh of relief from the goalie standpoint.
It's a bit of both. I mean, a part of me is like, whew, yes, it's not counting. But another part of me is like, shoot, that just went in.
Ooh. Oh, good play by Jovels. Reimer, thanks for the updates on the game. I wish they were in my favor, but... 4-2 for Florida now. And great save by G-Guard. Standing strong. Here
great
comes Habsy. Habsy tries to force that in there, and Tyke's going to hold on to that. 2-1 still here for the Maggles, ending almost the second period with almost 6 minutes left.
And Tyke doing a great job of holding that short side every time. Not moving at all.
Great back to Habs fan. That goes out of the zone, though. G Guard stays in his net. And B Plus is going to pick that up, get a zone entry here, maybe? No, he's playing around with it. We still maintain possession, though, luckily, and Cavi holds it with an LT or other spinorama.
Oh, almost was a touch pass there.
Breakout here for Whips. Bagels already have four guys back. They're looking into that ball again. Scrub City has to start moving that puck again.
Jay was still offsides.
And there goes Maggles into their blue line defense. LT by Mick Tricky gets stripped there. Over to the J-Whips, gets it down low.
Oh, clutch stick lift.
Yeah, Geezer getting tied up in front. Good play. Maggles are going to find another goal here. Habs fan sneaks it in there, and that's 3-1 for the Maggles. Timeout here for Scrub City.
How did that even go in?
Is TJ, I know Chad is like west or coast, like Pacific, mountain, whatever. Is TJ too or no?
Yes.
Oh, I wonder if that has like a sort of delay in net, because I feel like sometimes we think that it does help when it comes
100% matter. Yeah, it definitely makes a difference. Probably ping is probably most important for goalies, and then a very close second is center.
Can maybe see too if he's maybe not high enough in his crease on that.
It looks like it might have gone off his armpit. So it looks like he made the save, but he didn't.
Treeslove's trying to fight Jamie Benn, you dummy.
That's gotta stink for the goal. Love the name Hazfan, by the way.
Oh yeah, bad animation. Is a little low there though. It's on his crease. We got a milestone here. Not sure what's happening. It might be a milestone for the man.
Takes a lap. There's no replay skipping either, so we had to watch it.
Big hit there by Wildcard on Geezer.
Still plenty of time left, though.
This is routinely where you're going to see the Maggles kind of turn into that big ball in front of G Guard now.
Lane.
A lot of time left here still. We've got 1 minute left in the second. Jovels picks that up. Here comes the rush from the Script City. Geezer over to McTricky. Over to finds J Whips, and somehow G Guard's on his butt, finds that save, and still has it. Another save there. And he's going to hold that 3-1 lead going into the second, hopefully. There's 2.1 seconds left. Maybe one chance off this faceoff draw.
He's the most decorated goalie in Bar League history for a reason. Man.
And Maggles, we're going to take that draw. So they're going in 3-1 into the locker room. Going into the third period, looking nice, trying to close this series out in six. And you see Cavi here with his 1T off of that nice pass from Maggle.
That was his pride tape. We love it. All are welcome.
Him sporting the dab there, too.
Gotta love it. Classic.
You see Wildcard cleaning up on those truculent hits. Man, what a weird shot.
Yeah, was that did that go far or short?
Short.
Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't save that. You had the animation, too.
I thought it was tipped originally.
Does anyone else, when you see Scrub City, remember that song that's called Rack City? So I'm like, Scrub City, bitch, Scrub City, bitch. That's every single time. I can't get it out of my head.
I remember it. I would never.
You never would have connected that?
Not until now, no. I honestly forgot that song existed.
I didn't listen to a lot of rap in the 90s. Like, the rap that I knew was like Cisco.
Oh, that's 2010s.
Yo, Cisco with the song.
Yeah.
Calling that rap.
I was listening to the Chili Peppers in Linkin Park back then in like the early 2000s. So.
I get that, me too. R.I.P. Chester.
Beef Bus gets it down low. Cavi finds Wildcard at the point. Almost a tip there in front. That goes over the boards, over the glass. Yeah, Juvenile, Back That Ass Up. That was like a that was like the early 2000s.
About Ja Rule.
Yeah.
Some Jenny from the Block.
Good poke here. Scrub City with control. 2-on-2. Do get it down low, but too many numbers here for the Maggles.
It's runner right there. It is. Now go back to Cavi. Let him work.
Cavi's going to find it. That's 4-1. Maggles.
Yeah, yeah, he's good.
Is he good?
He's pretty good.
He has so much room there in the center.
Good on
Harrison. Little back and forth.
Now, Hampson is someone who I feel like is like a little quiet in this league, but I feel like he's always a good dude to play with. But sometimes I like forget he's even here because he doesn't really talk so much in chat, and he just kind of shows up to games.
I think ever since those DCHL days and the whatever the hell it turned into, ACHL?
ACHL or something.
Yeah, I feel like he's kind of matured a little bit more.
Tyke squeezes the pads. Good save. Keeping his team in it.
Plus, I think it matters like who he's around too. You get a bunch of clowns with him.
Oh, and another goal here. Maggle with a tipper. Great up in tipper. Front. 5-1 for the Maggles. They are eyeing season 9 championship.
Coming in as the 4 seed.
Oof. Nothing Tyke can do on that. And Maggles find themselves in a good prime position here. 5-1 with only 16 left in the third.
There is time, but I have a feeling there's going to be a lot of lot more passing done from the Maggles in this last 10 minutes.
They already have 4 back. They're starting to collapse already.
You see a little... few more resets.
Gabby going to work again.
Circling back to the point. Yep.
Good block by Geezer. Trying to get a Omaha there, but already Maggles with 3 back. Maggles playing with a lot of confidence right now. Dutifully so with 5-1 game, and Tyke makes that short side save. Gabby still has it though, and Geezer's going to finally pull that off of his stick. Tricky gets hit, big hit by Wild Card. A big hit by Geezer behind net, gets that to the point. B-Pack over to Jovels there, but that's get blocked. Habs fan with another LT. Can't find it short side. Great save by Tyke.
Loves that blocker.
And Cavi still has it. Has 5 guys chasing him. Gets it back to some Maggles. And Gretzky's office somehow gets a backhander shot that almost gets in front to Habs fan. Good poke check off of McTricky's stick there. Keeping this game 5-2. Only 8 minutes left in this game.
It's looking bleak for Scrub City.
They need to find something here fast.
Well, you know,
D-Guard stays tight. And J-Whip shoots it right at him. Had the left side open.
I was going to say, both Jay and Geezer have recorded so many hat tricks throughout this entire season and even, you know, throughout the entire playoffs. And it stinks that they're kind of coming up a little short and when it matters most.
Oof. Yeah.
No connection there. Another rush here from Scrub City. They have some numbers. It gets it poked.
Smothering defense by the Maggles.
Love to see it, though. Protect your lead.
My goodness.
The shot from the point. G-Guard's going to cover that up, though. 5 minutes left in this one. It's the Ford F-150 Final 5, and it is 5-1 in favor of the Maggles. Yeah, I think I don't want to like to call it, but
it's...
Like I said, though, man. You've got both... Geezer and Jay on the same team, on the same line. Like, these guys can light it up. It's just, do they have enough time to, and are they gonna get hot soon?
I've seen crazier things. You know, EA finds its way sometimes.
That's tough. And McTricky's injured too. Not looking good. But if you're the Maggles, looking pretty fucking good. It's a
5-1 hockey game. Face off here in the Maggles zone. The City wins it straight back. Tricky with a shot and great save off of Geezer's chance there. G-Guard holds his post. Here comes Maggle.
Playing unreal right now.
Maggle looking for that rebound tip, and that's going to be offside, Sarah Cavi. 3 minutes left. Maggles are salivating. Wanting to taste that cereal in that cup.
What a series.
Play by Jovels. Can't find J-Whips on that connection. No icing, though.
Just trying to get something going. Making the sloppy passes and stuff.
Minutes left. Here comes Maggles. Almost Cavi with another 1-2 chance. Gets that blocked by B-Pack. B-Pack cuts that off. J-Whips has a chance here. Wildcard right with him, though. LT. The Spinnerama, rather. And a 2-on-1 chance here for the Maggles.
Getting over
back. Oh, and that goes backhander. Maggle finding a second. That's going to close this one out. The Maggles are going to be your Season 9 champions. What a game. What a series that they played coming in at seed 4.
They had a much tougher road going up against the Riverhawks, the President's Trophy winners in the semifinals, and now going up against Grub City, who had been dominating the standings all season. Yeah, it's good to see. It's good hockey.
Tip your cap for them.
Yeah.
Tie up here. 50 seconds left.
And just so many bodies in front of the net for the Maggles.
Yeah, they're in that ball, that purple ball.
Oh, goodness.
Back check here by Geezer prevents another damage after the fact. Speedfush is trying to
sending some messages on Xbox.
He's setting up a lemonade stand out there.
Is the what happens coming in general? Is that what's going on?
We got a penalty here on the Maggles. Not going to matter much.
There's Jovels. Jovels posting it first in Discord.
Hey, both teams, I think, have a lot of love for each other, though, so.
Oh, yeah. Good group of guys on both sides. Even some of the Maggles coming over from that Toxics Season 7 IR squad and hanging around and just kind of changing the notes a little bit.
The walk there by Maggle. Showing off some of his stuff there.
You got to quit, too. The J-Whips with the lag out. We'll see.
And that's going to finish it off. The Maggles take game 6-1. They are your Season 9 Bar League champion, winning the Levesque Cup. Congratulations to them. What a great group of guys. Great team. Man, not only skill level, but great group of dudes too, just personality-wise and character-wise. So congratulations to them. I'm happy for them.
Yeah. Especially because it shows that like seeds don't matter, because Scrub City was number one. Maggle just eked into the playoffs.
I'm sure we'll probably find out who is your Conn Smythe. I can probably guess.
Who?
I don't want to be biased, but
I mean, Habs fan, played some pretty good games there too. So shout out to him. Cavi had some great games there coming in there too. Very good game 6. Maggle playing for most of those games too.
I know Hasfan had some votes in the chat earlier for MVP, but
I do just want to see that hit one more time. It was a good one, man. I'm just happy that my replay worked, man. That's what I'm more happy about, I think. But that hit was fucking nasty. But I just want to see that one more time here.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm just glad that I got my stream working there again after all that shit happened. So I lost my cloud saves. Fuck it.
Taking the series 4-2. Yeah, I'm almost dead even on stats. Just didn't make it to the score sheet.
Oh, I must have hit it again. I must. Whatever.
Too many shots.
All right, it worked once. It worked once. Hopefully, some people saw it. So. but yeah, I mean, damn, man, the Maggles just coming out and just. winning both of those series against two of the top teams there, man. And power out to them. It's good to see. It's good for the league, and I love all those guys on there too, man. They're not like you said, they weren't very toxic or anything. They're good dudes. I'm proud of them. I'm happy for them, man. Good shit. Congratulations on season 9 champions, man.
It was a great series overall by both teams.
Hey, okay. Welcome back.
Thank you.
I mean,
thank you.
Definitely, if anybody wants to come in here, you're more than welcome to now.
I don't think they can.
Server, so. Oh, no, you can't.
They don't see the channel, yeah.
Gotcha. I wish I could move them in or something, but I mean,
we could go to general, but.
Yeah, let's go. Right. Fuck it. Yeah, people want to come in there. So.
Yeah.
Just no end bombs or anything, please. Yeah. Just to keep it
simple.
Keep it simple.
Oh, yeah, you want to get some.
I will announce the owners for season 10.
Okay.
You got all of them already?
I do have them. Just let me get the list here.
I was going to say, well.
Hold on.
All right.
So, your owners for season 10 are the following.
Start with the Purple Cobras.
Jovals. Number one. Number two is Chad. Number three is Dadsmith.
Okay.
Number four is Geezer.
Uh-oh.
Interesting.
Number five is Doc, Crate Chief, whatever you want to call him. And our last owner, number six, is going to be Lusky.
Maybe right. More to come, though, possibly.
We do have some reserves on standby right at this moment if we do get the numbers for 8 teams. But those are your season 10 owners.
Nice.
Okay. I mean, a few Scrub City people are gonna break up there.
Who's owning the Purple Cobras?
That would be Joel's.
Joel's, okay.
We are actually called the Sin City Purple Cobras EEE Post Evers Era.
We appreciate
adding a little spin on it.
We like the breaking news from SportsCenter, Hoagie there. Appreciate that. We're gonna drop it into a Gen Chat. I mean, if Mac wants to get in or any of you guys there, you don't want to hop in, just like I said, keep it civil. Noah and Bombs are there, but we're gonna move into a Gen Chat, so feel free to come in if you want to voice your opinions about the game or just say whatever or say hello. Can find it though, isn't it?
Somewhere in the middle. But yeah, man.
Yeah, good games, man.
Serious.
Yeah, that was I wish we were able to stream the first two. Unfortunate that I was playing in the first. I mean, not unfortunate, but I mean, I played the first two games. I wish we could have got you all of the series because all those games are just fan fucking tastic. So. But yeah, congratulations again for the Maggles winning the season 9. So Fly doesn't have to lose that tag that he already had as a season 9 champion on his name. So congratulations to them, man. Again, like I said, man, I'm happy for them. They played great, great squad. And you know, I mean, it's good stuff to Scrub City too. They made it very far. Good group of guys as well, and I enjoyed playing with them. Chad's a good dude and. Was a good leader and good management there too, and they just came up a little bit short. But you know, we're looking forward to season 10 here. We got some new owners. Looks like Scrub City is going to break it up a little bit. So a lot of them being your new GMs here, or whatever you call them. I guess is a GM or yeah GMs. Looking for what are we? I'm just seeing what Fly said in there. Left a lot. It must have. Carried over and been charged changed from IR season. Yeah, it's a definitely yeah. But yeah, no, I'm glad to see a lot of these guys that are returning in the league. So like this group's always been Discord's always been a very close knit community. A lot of dudes return. I mean, it's always good to see new people. So we're always welcoming. Greatness, want to give you the stats there for our league.
Oh yeah.
What's Jovals?
Oh my god, who we got in there?
Jovals making an entrance here.
Jovals in there.
I can't help but wonder, Jovals. It had to be the build. I mean, that's got to be the downfall.
It was the build.
Build all season. Send it, man. It was, boy.
It was the build all season.
Irritated me.
It works, man.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
Not as much as tape to tape.
It does, I promise. You know who gave me that build? You know what's hilarious about that?
Well, it wasn't Geezer.
No, what was it?
That's who you should have been taking your build from.
It was Maggle.
Ah, see? It was a little sabotage.
Yeah. From day one. The long game.
I saw you. It worked out. I think you were running magnetic for a bit. And I was like, well, that's just wrong. And then,
That was early, though. That was early. Yeah.
So, Scrub City is breaking up, man. So you're going to be taking charge.
Yeah, congrats on the ownership.
Oh, did that get out?
Yeah.
I don't know if that was.
Yeah, I heard AGM was Evers, too. So.
Honestly, I blame the games tonight on the Evers curse from season one. We, obviously, what happened, and then we made it to the finals. We were, just like this year, we were the best team, like, all season. And then we made it to the finals and couldn't win.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's still haunting me.
Technically, the Riverhawks are the best team. But
oh, I guess that's true.
Record-wise. And a lot of stats-wise. But that's true. One team did have Geezer and the other one didn't, so.
I just have one question to ask you. What happened?
Jesus.
You got mangled by the Maggles?
It's okay. We're making a return. Season 10 reunion. Evers is coming back.
Okay, man. Are you going to pay the $50 ban that Chad put on him?
Is that a thing? I don't know those things.
That's, no.
Bounties? I'd go for that.
1 year That's subscription funny. Towards Chad's OnlyFans.
Does Chad have an OnlyFans?
It's just him getting fucked in the ass by Chell over and over again.
He sells the highest of quality feet pics.
Is that so?
Yeah, I have my sources.
Well, I mean, he's got 13 children, so I think it's 13.
13 and counting? No, he has
four. Yeah. What? That's not true at all.
I was hoping one of the Maggles might come in here there. But
from his OnlyFans.
So yeah, we got a bunch of OGs returning with myself and Joel's this season. We have Hetsy as our AGM.
Oh, we already have AGMs and everything, like secures and stuff already?
Well,
I don't think those are.
We're going owner, GM, and AGM. Excuse me.
Okay. Let's go!
Dad Bob's in here.
What's going on, Dad Bob?
Don't. Why does it sound weird? Let's go! Bring in the boys!
This is actually hot off the press, too. I heard Greatness is buying an Xbox and playing next season as well, too. So.
I would like to I'd like to shout out to my dad, G-Goad. He's the greatest goalie in the game.
Not that much, man.
I can neither confirm nor deny the Green Men might make an appearance.
Green Man.
That's what I said.
You said Green Men.
The gay men? You can't say that.
Jeez.
G-Guard is in the chat here too. And Geezer as well.
Geezer.
Dad Bob's going to just singing Raining Men. I don't know where.
I think you're getting a warning. Hang on.
Reimer did actually have a question. I actually was curious too. When does World Cup start?
World Cup is starting next week. Teams have been made already, but I am keeping signups open until Friday to fill the last couple spots.
Gotcha. Discords and stuff too? Or
Did I get picked?
Did you sign up for the World Cup? Yeah, you did. You're on a team of Jingle. And Jaywards.
Let's go.
When was I going to find this out?
Well, it's in announcements.
It's in announcements. We did the draft 2 days early. So
It's public knowledge.
Hold on.
Hold on, I'm old. Leave me alone. Oh shit, I clicked the wrong button.
Yeah. Yeah, you know that tab you have muted?
Oh, the stuff with the colors that I completely didn't look at because it hurt my eyes. Got it. I am
Flame Hoagie.
While we have a G-Guard and a Geezer in here, I just wanted to get maybe some. I don't want to keep everybody on too long, so just curious if they wanted anything to say. You got the mic while you're here.
Oh, am I live right now?
Yeah. You are live right now.
Yeah, fuck it. Sorry about the gay comment, everybody.
That comment was brought to you by Bud Light.
I will say every playoff series that I've played against G Guard, it has always been a battle of how do I get this past him? Like, how do I help my team get this past him?
Well, you found out how to do that in game 5.
Yeah, but game 6, he just shut the door.
There were like, so many that should have gone in. It was ridiculous.
And I will say that definitely it was a hell of a series. You know, we knew coming in. And I said earlier in the Barge In chat, I said, you know, we knew what they were capable of doing, yeah, more than capable of what they were doing, you know, seeing and experienced it. So, you know, we knew we were in for a hell of a fight and hell of a battle, and then that's what we got.
Tika, I did want to ask a question, like, what was it like playing opposite, you know, the man, the myth, the one who makes your lady miss, you know, the man of the hour, the tower of power, the man too sweet to be sour? Like, what was it like facing Geezer?
It's almost you know, it's the guy you definitely keep an eye on. You know, the putts are in the corners, and you definitely, you know, keep your peripheral on where that guy is, because you know, it's coming to him. And if he's carrying it, you know, you definitely got to watch what he's doing, because you know the talent is there, and it's overwhelming. Being able to do pretty much anything, you know, as the saying goes, you can only hope to contain them. You can't stop them. You can only hope to contain them.
Hey, man. The man too cool for talking and never stops walking.
So
he's one of the greatness. Are so good.
The reflection of perfection. What you see is what you get, and what you don't is better yet.
Keep it going, man. Don't stop.
I was going to say, I'm just, you know, just listening to it. But
Big fan.
Yeah, I would say that three of those games too, right in the middle, where there were one goal games there, were very pivotal. So this series could have definitely went either way. Both teams played really good, but that bulk of that series really happened in the middle. Just one goal separating, you know, those wins. So.
Maggle sneaking out game 3 and 4 was huge. I wish we could have seen those streams, because those were some incredible clutch moments there. It was something.
Yeah, definitely. Most of those games, you know, even the games that weren't ended up one goal games, they were you know, one goal games, two goal games for a long period of time, and then you know, as it goes, whoever's behind, you got to press, you know, and that leads to opportunities and whatnot. But you know, it was definitely, you know, hard fought all the way for sure.
Yeah.
I don't want to keep everybody too long, so I'm going to kind of end it here, but I just want to say again, congratulations to the Maggles there for winning season 9.
Maggles.
Congratulations to Scrub City making it to the finals as well. Both teams played really great. It was fun to watch, fun to be a part of as well. It's always great to be a part of this league. Again, it's you know, Bar League hockey. Again, if you don't, you know, aren't a part of it, and you'd like to be, I'll put a Discord link in there for you. But that was just a, you know, little snippet of what we offer. We got World Cup coming. If you didn't hear that, you know, earlier from Hoagie, and you got some of the players in here. You heard their reactions, and what a great series! What a great community to be a part of. So, just want to say thank you to everybody in this community. I love all you guys, and I look forward to season 10.
And I should have probably said this earlier, but thank you, Jingle, Greatness, Sammy, Hoagie, you know, Big D, everybody that contributes to the media. And gives you know, gives his presence, you know, out there in the wide world. It's greatly appreciated. You know, you guys are always on, everybody's always on point. It's always it's a great thing to experience, and really appreciate it.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I also agree with that. You guys have been a big help to both since you guys came in and are doing this, and it's greatly appreciated among everybody in here in the community. It's, I mean,
it gets people more active. I mean, the game of the night, game of the week, it brings the community together more. It keeps everybody involved. And even with the weekly shows that D and Hollywood have been doing so far, I mean, that's been a big hit as well, getting all the special guests on. So, I mean, it's all this media stuff for the league can be proved to be big. And it's proven to be big so far for Bear. And I hope that we keep on moving up and up and hopefully getting more teams and getting more people involved and everything.
Back to the glory days. Volzy coming in to the media team this season, too. So. Yes.
And we got an awards committee team too, and it's, you know, we're starting to get, hopefully, as, I mean, we're in season 10 already, but we're hopefully that season 10 is going to be the big 10th anniversary. And we're hopefully, you know, going to provide the league with a great season. I mean, we've got some pretty high quality owners for season 10, as I read off the list there before. So, I mean, I think season 10 is going to be a doozy, and it's looking good. I can't wait, and hopefully everybody else can't wait either, because I mean it's shaping up to be a good one. So make sure to sign up.
It's gonna be an interesting season next season for sure.
Can't believe you're owning.
Get to put in a full season. Let's go.
It's so as always, as greatness promotes, Monday to Friday, 9:45.
It's Monday through Wednesday. But
Monday through Wednesday.
Are you doing that? Management hikes.
Monday to Wednesday, 9:45. Come check us out. We're glad to have you. We're happy to have you.
All right. We're going to get out of here. Again, congratulations on the win there to the Maggle Season 9 victors. We'll see you all for Season 10. Thanks for joining us. Take care.